Welcome students. Welcome to National Institute of Open Schooling. Today's topic is statistics. You are aware in stats we deal with collection and interpretation of data. For this purpose we work upon measures of central tendencies such as mean, median and mod. Now in order to interpret the data correctly we need to be aware of the spread, the scattering of data around the measure of central tendencies. In order to understand the scattering, consider runs scored by two batsmen A and B. Here we observe that mean of both batsmen is same, that is 53. Does this mean that their performance is also same? No. If you observe the range, here range of A is 117, whereas range of B is less. Now let us plot their runs on a number line. So here you observe the vertical line shows the mean runs and the different dots represent their runs. In case of A, scattering is more, but in case of B, dots are close and cluster around the mean scores. That means in case of B, reliability is more, his performance has been consistent. So we say B is a better performer. So this scattering is a part of dispersion. So let us understand more about different measures of dispersion. The very first measure is range, and we are aware range is the difference between maximum observation and minimum observation. Let us take one question. Find the range of this given data. Here maximum observation is 13 and minimum observation is 4. So range comes out as 13 minus 4, that is 9. So let us move to next dispersion measure. This is known as mean deviation from mean. Now as the name suggests, mean deviation is the deviation of all observations from the mean. So you are aware that data can be in two forms, ungrouped data and grouped data. So let us work upon ungrouped data first. In ungrouped data, you are aware that frequency is not given. So mean deviation is summation I varies from 1 to n mod of xi minus x bar upon n. Let us find mean deviation of given data. So first of all we need to find mean, and you are aware mean is sum of observations divided by number of observations. Here number of observations is 5. So we find the sum which comes out as 50. So mean is equal to 50 upon 5, that is 10. Now in case of formula of mean deviation, we had mod of x minus x bar. So x bar we have got. Let us take deviation of all observations from this mean. So these deviations are mod of 8 minus 10, mod of 7 minus 10 and so on. And these result in mod of minus 2, mod of minus 3, mod of 0, mod of 2 and mod of 3. Now you are aware that mod value means positive values are taken. So minus 2 mod is equal to 2. Similarly, we get deviations of all the observations from their mean. Therefore, mean deviation from mean is sum of these deviations, that is 2 plus 3 plus 0 plus 2 plus 3 divided by number of observations, and it comes out as 2. Now let us move to grouped data. You are aware grouped data further can be of two types, discrete frequency distribution and continuous frequency distribution. In both the cases, mean deviation remains the same. Only thing is that in case of continuous frequency distribution, we take the class intervals. So let us find the mean deviation of given data. Here class intervals are given. So the very first column works upon class marks. Let us work upon this given data. Here it is a continuous frequency distribution. So first of all, we need to find the class marks. So the column xi in table shows the class marks, that is the middle value of all the classes. Next column, we need to find mean. So in order to find mean, we shall be having product of fi xi. So next column is fi xi. Now using this concept, firstly we will find mean. So mean is summation fi xi divided by summation f, and that comes out to be 45. So let's come back to the table again then. Now we have got the value of mean. So let's find deviation of all observations from this mean. So next column is mod of xi minus x bar. Now we need product of frequency and these deviations. So last column shows this product. Now let us use the formula for mean deviation for a continuous frequency distribution. It says summation I varies from 1 to n fi into mod of xi minus x bar whole divided by n. Here this n shows summation f. So mean deviation comes out to be 10. So friends, these are two measures of dispersion. We still have two more, but let us revise these first. So first dispersion measure is range, that is maximum observation minus minimum observation. And second is mean deviation from mean. For this, we have summation I varies from 1 to n fi mod of xi minus x bar whole divided by n. If you have any queries, you can contact us at www.nios.ac.in. Thank you.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे बनिए प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।
Welcome to National Institute of Open Schooling. Today we will learn about statistics. So we are learning about two more measures of dispersion. These are variance and standard deviation. Variance is defined as mean of squares of deviations from the mean. So we have learned earlier that how do we find deviations. Today we will work upon this further. Variance is denoted as sigma square. Data can be given in two forms, ungrouped and grouped data. For ungrouped data, variance is sigma square is equal to 1 upon n summation I varies from 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square. If you recall the mean deviation from mean, that time we were working with absolute values. In variance, we are working with squares of this. So already these are positive values. Similarly, for grouped data, variance is shown as summation I varies from 1 to n fi into xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. After variance, we have standard deviation. Standard deviation is basically positive square root of variance. So for grouped and ungrouped data, standard deviation is shown. Let us find the variance and standard deviation for the given data. Now, if you recall the formulas, we are working with mean. So for given data, we need to find mean. And mean is summation fi xi upon summation f. So first of all, we find the column fi xi. Here value comes out as 1350 and summation f is 50. So mean value comes out to be 27. Let's complete the table now. In variance, we have xi minus x bar whole square. So once the value of mean is obtained, we go for all the values. So xi minus x bar column. The next column shows square of xi minus x bar. The last column being fi xi minus x bar whole square. And all the values are obtained. Now, variance is, so let us substitute all the values in the formula for variance. So, this comes out as 6600 divided by n, that is 50. So, variance comes out to be 132. Let us move to standard deviation. Since standard deviation is positive square root of variance. So here we get standard deviation as square root of 132, which is 11.4. Now, if you recall, we are working with mean. What if mean is in decimals? That results in very cumbersome calculations. In order to reduce these calculations, we have one more form of finding variance, where we do not deal with mean. observe this formula for variance when mean is not calculated. Now, if data is given, we will work upon these variables, that is fi xi and fi xi whole square. Let us find the standard deviation for the given data. So, the very first step being to find mean. Here we find that mean is in decimals. Since mean is in decimals, so we will use new form of variance formula. For that, we need to find xi square and next column would be fi xi square. So, these values are obtained. Now, let us put these values in the given formula and we get value of variance as 6.12. Now, if you observe these calculations, here also calculations are quite big. We are dealing with product of big numbers. So, do we have a shortcut? Yes, we have one more formula, one more method, which is known as step deviation method. Here values are reduced so that calculations become easy. So, observe the formula. So, xi is changed to different set of observations, that is ui and u bar, where ui is equal to xi minus a upon h, where a is an arbitrary class mark and h is the class interval. So, the new form becomes variance is equal to h square upon n square within bracket n summation fi ui square minus square of summation fi ui. Now, we work upon different columns showing all these variables. So, here value of a has been taken as 65. Value of a is chosen so that it lies in the middle of all the observations. So, ui square is found, then we find product of fi and ui. Next column is for fi ui square. Now, we find the summations of these values. So, n is equal to summation f, that comes out to be 50. Summation fi ui is minus 15 and summation fi ui square is equal to 105. So, put these values and now we get the variance as 201. Here we observe that calculations are easier because we are dealing with small numbers now. Now, standard deviation is square root of variance. So, this becomes square root of 201, that is 14.18. Let us work upon properties of variance and standard deviation. First property is when something is added or subtracted from all the observations, there is no change in variance or standard deviation. Similarly, when each observation is multiplied by a constant k, new variance is k square times the original variance. Let us sum up all the measures of dispersion. Range is highest observation minus lowest observation. Mean deviation has been shown for raw data and grouped data. Then is variance and standard deviation. For ungrouped data, where no frequency is involved, formulas are shown. For grouped data, variance and standard deviations are shown. All the formulas are shown where we can work upon mean, where mean is in decimals and where we want to work upon reduced calculations. So now you know, if data is ungrouped, then which formulas we need to use? Here we do not have frequency. Accordingly, variance and standard deviation are worked upon. We find mean, then deviation of all observations from this mean and their mean value. And if data is grouped one, then class marks are taken, their means are found, and if mean is in decimals, then we have a separate formula. And if we want to work upon reduced calculations, then we have step deviation method. If you have any queries related to measures of dispersion, you can contact us at www.nios.ac.in. Thank you.
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर NIOS के साथ। आप भी जुड़िए NIOS के संग।
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने
पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से